They have to win no matter what to prolong the series. Rob Sinclair has more on tonight's game.
The Devils came off the ice in Game 5 knowing they had the Rangers on the ropes. But as they have all series, the Devils are taking nothing for granted.
We're a confident group, but then again, we're not overconfident. We don't want to get complacent at this point. We just want to get out there and get that first couple shifts out of the way and try to get in there and get some early chances.
The Rangers, meantime, have a curse upon them and history against them, not to mention a red-hot rookie named Martin Brodeur.
All throughout the playoff, you know, that's what you try to do. You know, you try to play well and make at least the odd save, and sometimes you get the big save. You know, I remember few save I did against the Buffalo series, you know, and that could have been the big difference right there. But now it's a new series, so whatever we do, you know, a goal or a save, you know, it doesn't really matter who's doing it, you know, it's the team now. We just want to be out there and win.
The Devils are confident because they're thriving when faced with adversity. They've handed the Rangers their only two losses at home during the playoffs after failing to win at Madison Square during the regular season. They've used the suspension of Bernie Nichols as incentive to win Game 4 and his return to win Game 5.
I hope they were excited to have me back. I felt that I had to go out and help the team out the best I could because of missing Game 4, and things just worked out great for us. And, you know, the way we're playing right now, we definitely have to carry that over to Game 6, and we feel if we play Game 6 the way we play 4 and 5, then we got a great opportunity to beat this team.
But by the same token, the Rangers have some experienced players who in the past have also overcome adversity.
We had very few downs in our season. We were always able to jump out the next game and sort of turn things around. This is obviously our biggest mountain to climb, and the pressure's on them now. They have to win at home, or at least they'll feel they'll have to win at home, and we got to go out and play maybe a little more, a little tighter game, and you know, maybe a little more relaxed game.
In other words, the Rangers are feeling the pressure, and so they should. The Devils are underdogs, and they've used that as an incentive, too.
We're playing against a team now that we're not supposed to beat. Everybody has picked New York to win, and only the 20 guys in the dressing room, the coaches and management, feel that we can win. And, you know, we've had proven that, but we haven't put them out yet. And until we do that, you know, they're still top dog, but we definitely feel that we're capable of doing that.
So could it be too late for the Rangers? Well, the first time they trailed in this series, they came back to win the next two straight, including one at the Meadowlands. But what's also important to keep in mind is the Devils aren't the type of team to make the same mistake twice. Rob Sinclair, TSN, at the Eastern Conference Finals.